I agree, it's really confusing. People say you need Google My Business, and then suddenly you're told it's Google Business Profile. What exactly is it, and what is it you need? And you try to understand it. Is it something to do with Google Maps? Is it to do with a search engine? Is it an index where you just go and register your business? Well, this video is going to explain all those things. It's going to put it in easy terms so you can understand it and feel confident that you know exactly what Google Business Profile is. And of course, if you follow this channel, you'll know that you can increase the benefits by optimizing your Google Business Profile, and you can see the difference just even within a month. So make sure you subscribe and click the like button and the alert button if you want to make sure that you don't miss out on the next video. So what is Google Business Profile? Well, it's a simple way of registering your business in Google. It means Google then can put it in local results, a search engine, Google Maps. Your business shows locally to people that are looking for your type of business. So why does it keep getting called different names? On November the 4th, 2021, it was changed from Google My Business to Google Business Profile. Why? Well, because Google wanted to simplify it. It wanted to make it easier for you to access the information so that you can keep your business updated. So how do you actually manage your business today? Well, you can either go to Google Maps or you can go to the search engine and just search for your business. If it's existing, you can claim it. If you've already updated it or you've already registered it, then you can edit it and keep it updated. But part of the simplification was that Google wants you to keep things updated. In fact, on a video just recently, I showed you there's a couple of strategies you can use. Google wants me to view a message and respond to it. And so it's much more interactive now every time I log into my browser, and I can then make those changes. How do you get support in Google Business Profile? Well, whenever you see the three dots, generally there's a help and support section there. So use that, and you can register then any concerns you have with them if you feel something's been misrepresented. Okay, so in simple terms, what is it Google's looking for from me? Well, they want you to have a local business, but also they want you to think local, to link local, and to have citations that are local. And when you have those three things, Google knows then that you are a local business to the person searching for you. So what you're doing in effect is building up local authority. So it's not the same as standard national SEO, search engine optimization. This is a slightly different way of being found, but it's more likely that your customers are local to you. So from a small business point of view, this is the perfect scenario. Now, I've heard that Google Business App is going to disappear. Is that true? Absolutely. So Google, as part of the simplification, when it renamed on November the 4th, also decided it was going to get rid of the app. Why? Because the app was quite complicated. Half the functionality didn't exist. Whereas with Google Business Profile within a browser, you can access it using your mobile or using your desktop. So how does Google decide who's going to be above me? And how can I get in that top three map pack, as it's often referred to? Well, first of all, Google's changing the layout and it's going to be a five pack soon, but also there's hundreds of parts to the algorithm. And so I've looked at these over the past few years and I explain them, and we try and do things Google's way, but at the same time, we're not there to please Google, we're there to please customers. But what happens if I go to my business and it still says it needs a verification? Well, basically what's happened is Google needs to send you a way of verifying your business. Normally it comes by means of a postcard, but sometimes video conferencing. Why can it take so much time though for me to get people and clients phoning me, even though I'm starting to appear in the search engine results? Well, just bear in mind, it takes at least 12 visits searching, looking at various products, reading reviews, researching again, and eventually after about 12 times, they'll then contact and they'll then make a purchase. So there's a whole process, and that's why authority and consistency are needed for businesses. Why is it that everyone's going on about Google Business Profile? Well, you'll notice with Google, it gives you marketing tools, which we've covered in a previous video, and it also gives you advertising for free. In fact, you'll know that if you advertise, you probably won't get the same returns as a well-optimized Google Business Profile. And yet all of this is for free. That's why there's so much hype. So should I just focus on pleasing Google? Well, that's what most people think. That's not the right way to go about it. As you can see here, understanding how Google works, Google actually wants accurate data from you. So you need to put your information into Google and make sure it's accurate. Make sure it also appeals to customers. Google knows whether customers are finding it interesting and helpful. Customers want to find useful events and businesses. They want to see relevant results. results. And Google also wants to show relevant results. You can work with Google by pleasing your customers as a priority. And this is what most people get wrong. Following this process, we'll certainly see an increase on a long-term basis. So you mentioned earlier advertising. Should I advertise as well as have my Google Business Profile? Well, Google Business Profile comes with £80 of credit or the equivalent in your country, and you may want to use that and just see whether it works for you. In fact, every category, every type of business, and every location will vary. So it could be that Google Ads may work for you. But if you get your business optimized correctly, then you'll get that constant traffic for free. And that's probably the process I'd say you need to focus more on, is optimizing your Google Business Profile. Of course, the trouble is Google doesn't just immediately put you to number one, because you have to prove that you're an authority. But you can prove you're an authority if you know what to optimize and how to optimize it. So it'd be great if you have 13 tips that your competitors don't use to optimize their websites and their businesses with. Well, if you want to know more about those 13 tips, then head over to this video and I'll show you what you can do for Google Business Profile and 13 things your competitors aren't doing. I'll see you there.